most of high school, I was interested in pursuing medicine. I really started to fall in love with research when I began sort of my undergraduate thesis project, which was looking at the phylogeography of the rufous-colored sparrow. So I do call myself a computational biologist. Right now I work with a lot of gene expression data. I definitely learn how to code by necessity. I learned to code because I had to do it. It was a means of survival.
Tom Friedman's latest book, Thanks for Being Late, well, he says education is so key, and you go back to the three R's, reading, writing, arithmetic. But he said beyond the three R's, he said we need four C's. And for him, the four C's are creativity, communication, collaboration, and fourthly, coding. But above those four C's, for me, there's a more fundamental C, and that is curiosity.
I'm Joelle Pineau. I'm a faculty member in the School of Computer Science at McGill University, and I'm also the managing director of Facebook AI Research. I would say every step of the way, from choosing to go into engineering to even how I make decisions today, a lot of that is just curiosity. One of the major achievements of our lab is to actually show that you could take a particular class of AI systems called reinforcement learning algorithms and use this to personalize treatment strategies. For example, to train systems that can predict when epileptic seizures are going to happen based on EEG signals from patient, and used it to change how neurostimulation is applied to prevent and abort seizures. We built prototypes of robotic wheelchairs.
She uses creativity to come up with these ideas. It takes creativity to figure out how to initially work with and or process this data, but then to figure out in exactly all the different applications that you could apply your method. I mean, it's another challenge in itself.
We're very lucky in Montreal because we do have this sort of cluster of excellence in AI. Meanwhile, our research centers in medicine have had a really strong tradition in clinical research.
I'm really interested in connecting the medical community and the ecological community. So right now in my project, I'm really focused on how can we use growth and progression of a cancer tumor, compare that to population increase or decline of a species. It's one thing to do data analysis. It's another thing to do it productively. I am also a freelance opera singer. To me, it's a reset. If you're constantly getting yourself involved in other things, I do believe that really helps your creativity. Creativity is absolutely stemmed by an innate curiosity.
What you want to do with that curiosity is to develop the sense of innovation, which is very simply making things better.
I see so many possibilities in this world of data. Data has so much to offer. You never know what that breakthrough is going to be.